Hey everybody, this is TJR. If this is your first time here, welcome. If not, welcome back. And today we're going to talk about the 2022 Revolver Remix. I began by doing a previous video where I just did an unboxing. You can see that video, I'll leave a link for you. This is part two where I discuss the remix, and in particular, I compare the remix to the original stereo mix. To do this, I make use of the 2009 remasters of the original stereo mix because I don't own any original 60s stereo mixes that I can compare it to. And in particular, if I was going to do that right, I would need the British stereo mixes from the 60s, not the American ones or the Capitol Records ones, which I understand sound like garbage. Now, if you've seen my previous videos on the previous remixes, I have always, from the very beginning, been a very big fan of these remixes. I have at times found them to be revelatory, sometimes enhancing the background vocals, making them sound more full and more sublime, allowing me to hear audio nuances and textures that I previously had not heard before, and overall, allowing me to feel more like I am in the room with the instruments and the rest of the band. Now, I want to backtrack a little bit. In 2009, when I first heard the mono mix of Sgt. Pepper, back when they released the mono box set, my reaction was that the mono mix was now my go-to version of Sgt. Pepper. In 2017, when I heard the new remix of Sgt. Pepper, I updated that opinion and declared that the new 2017 remix is now my new go-to version of Sgt. Pepper. And with all the previous remixes that have been released so far, I have ended up going with the remixes as my new sexier model that I have moved on to. But with this new Revolver remix, I have to say that I have found myself feeling a bit torn, a bit less willing to let go of the original 1966 stereo mix in lieu of the original. Now, prior to getting my hands on the new Super Deluxe edition of Revolver, I did listen to reviews from other YouTubers out there. In his own video review of the 2022 mix, Mike at the InGroove channel expressed issues that both he and many others feel are inherent in the original stereo mix. As an example, he discussed how Ringo's drums felt buried in a lot of its tracks and how this new mix fixed those problems. But then he added that all those fixes also made it, how shall I say, not sound like Revolver. Similarly, Steve Guttenberg over at the Audiophiliac channel also discussed the same thing. He recognized that there were problems with the original stereo mix, a lot of this due to the album's hard left and right separation, pointing out, for instance, the jarring entry of Paul McCartney's lead vocal entering from the right side as an example. Just like Mike over at the InGroove channel, he said that the new mix fixed this, but that now, oddly enough, it doesn't sound like Revolver to him anymore. And I'll have to admit, I was tempted to respond in the comments of both their channels and say, be careful what you wish for. But I can't do that because I have to admit that I am not unfamiliar with what they are experiencing. In my youth, I once bought a brand new LP from a favorite band of mine. And I took it home, I played it, and there was a skip right on the opening track during the guitar solo. Now, the circumstances of that time made it too hard for me to return it, so I just lived with it. In time, that skip became familiar to me to the point that many years later, when I finally upgraded to a CD copy, it just sounded wrong to my ears. But eventually, I got over it and I accepted it. If this were a written review, I would have a big LOL right after that. When talking about the 1966 mix of this album, there is what I personally describe as a block-like stereo sound to it. This is derived from the hard left and hard right separation on a lot of the tracks. And it's this sound that I think for a lot of older folks, myself included, that has defined the sound of this album for us. And I'll be honest, this is something that I was not expecting to experience when listening to the new remix. On the 2022 mix of Revolver, I found everything to just be a lot smoother sounding. But when making my comparisons, the original mix, at times, felt tougher and more taut as a result. As I moved track by track on this album, I found myself at times preferring the original mix on some of the album's tracks and the newer mix on others. And there were times with some of the tracks that I had to say to myself, it's a draw. You see, this time around, and unlike previous remixes in this series, I found myself discovering very few subtle nuances that I hadn't previously heard on the original. In this particular instance, there were no really huge revelations when listening to this new mix. There was almost nothing new that I hadn't heard before. There was instead just a wider soundstage. And as I listened and compared track by track, I also found myself making an additional comparison to each track's original mono mix as well. In the process of doing this, it feels clear to me that Giles Martin and Sam O'Kell continually refer to the original mono mix as a guide when creating this new stereo mix, with one very noticeable exception, or perhaps I should say two noticeable exceptions. On Sgt. Pepper, there were a lot of very different noticeable audio elements that were unique to both the stereo and mono mixes. A good example is the Sgt. Pepper reprise. Paul's call out on the Sgt. Pepper reprise of the mono mix is pretty much inaudible on the original stereo mix. And John, or maybe it's George, I'm not sure who, saying goodbye during the count-off of the original stereo mix of the reprise is not present in the mono mix. In situations like this, an exception was made, and both elements were combined so that you get what I would refer to as a best-of-both-worlds mix. Not so in the 2022 Revolver mix. The mono mix of Got to Get You Into My Life features a longer fade-out and more horn swells. The guitar solo on Tomorrow Never Knows has a completely different audio effect on it that makes it sound more menacing than its stereo version, which is why I ended up preferring the mono version of Tomorrow Never Knows over the stereo version back when those two 2009 sets were released. So unlike the aforementioned Sgt. Pepper mix, these unique audio elements on the Revolver mono mix are not added to this new stereo mix. So in other words, there is no best of both worlds version here. Now, in his introduction to the Super Deluxe Edition's hardcover book, Giles Martin writes that he doesn't believe you should be listening to the technology, that you should instead be listening to the songs and not the remix. And this was another guiding principle I feel that must have pervaded the engineering sessions between him and Sam O'Kell. Because as a result, I feel like this is their most subtle entry into this remix series. For the entirety of Revolver, it appears to my ears that Giles Martin and Sam O'Kell looked at the problems inherent in the original stereo mix, listened to the fullness of the mono mix, and then tried to reproduce that fullness in stereo and then applied a larger soundstage. Since I didn't find any real new audio subtleties or revelations on this new mix, I initially thought that this review would be more of a track-by-track technical comparison. But in all honesty, all the technical comparisons I need to make, I just summed up in my last paragraph. So instead, I think I will just discuss how I emotionally reacted to each version and declare the winner on each track, unless, of course, it's a draw. So let's start with Taxman. On Taxman, the stereo mix works. Ringo's drum fills are a bit more in front and less buried. There is a lot more separation between the "if you drive my car" answer and callback vocals. During this portion of the song, you can actually feel the space between these. Also, Paul's bass has a bit more thump to it. And no longer does the lead guitar break come at you from the right side. Instead, it comes straight at you, just like it does in the mono mix. But with all that said, I honestly think I prefer the tighter soundstage of the original 60s mix, for now at least. With Eleanor Rigby, I feel like I am listening in a cold, dark cathedral when I listen to it in its original mix. It emotionally feels darker and colder, but in a really good way. On the new stereo mix, I feel like I'm listening to it in a well-lit, comfortable concert hall. But when I listen to it in its new mix, I don't lose any of its profound sadness as a result. Neither of these experiences feel better or worse, in my opinion. They are just different. So it really is a draw with these two in regards to Eleanor Rigby. I'm Only Sleeping. I enjoyed the new mix. It feels a bit more psychedelic, but at times I have to say the bass guitar felt a little too prominent and even a bit disruptive to the other instruments. So for now, I am preferring the original 1966 mix over it. On Love You Too, I have to say I feel the reverse. Again, I can't get over some of the contradictory feelings I have on all of this. In my A to B comparisons, the original mix feels very boxed in versus the new mix, which feels more free and more in tune with the whole Eastern Zen vibe that I think George Harrison was going for. Now, I have to say I swing back on Here and There and Everywhere. I prefer the more taut and tighter sound of the original stereo mix from the 60s on this one. It just feels more intimate and more cozy than the original. Now, I'm going to break track order for this next one and discuss both Yellow Submarine and Got to Get You Into My Life. One of the great things about this remix series is how it has given me more appreciation for some of my less favorite tracks on their respective albums. Sgt. Pepper's Good Morning, Good Morning felt to me a lot edgier in its new mix, and I appreciated how they brought out the country and rockabilly guitar elements of Octopus Garden. I ended up appreciating these two tracks a whole lot more. Previously, these were both tracks that I might have skipped over depending on my mood, even though I did like them. On the new mix, Yellow Submarine felt more jovial and more raucous, and I felt myself wanting to dance to it more than I've ever felt before. One of my problems with the original mix of Got to Get You Into My Life is just how thin and even a bit harsh the horns sound at the opening and how buried Ringo's drum fills are. In the new mix, the opening horns still feel a bit thin, but maybe a little less harsh, and that's probably just a limitation of the source material, but Ringo's drums are less buried, and the whole soundstage feels more free and loose, whereas it felt so small on the original. So I'm going with the newer mix on this one. She Said is one of the rare exceptions on this new remix where I did hear some audio nuances that I had not previously heard before. There was this cool guitar overdub that you hear at the beginning and that moves in and out through the majority of the track that I have to admit was pretty much buried on the original. But that is not the reason or the primary reason why I prefer it over the original mix. I really do think that overall the track just really benefits from the wider soundstage on the new mix, and it also feels more ethereal for it. Good day, sunshine. I am really on the fence with this one. Admittedly, the wider soundstage sounds really nice, and it feels a lot more open with the new mix. But there is just something about the more taut and tighter soundstage of the original that has its own unique charm as well. So on this one, for the time being, it's a draw. Over the years, I have had no problem with the original mix of And Your Bird Can Sing. But after comparing it to this new mix, I have to say that the original feels like a bird trapped in a box. And with this new mix, that bird has been set free. If I was going to make a mix playlist of these two, I would just remove the original mix in favor of the new one. For No One. I hear the bass grace notes played on the keyboard so much clearer in the new mix, and the drama and the sadness of this song is so much more pronounced and heightened, in my opinion, on the new mix. The new stereo mix is the clear winner on this one. The same goes for the follow-up track, Dr. Robert. I feel that the bass on this new remix is a bit overpowering and once again a bit disruptive of the other instruments. I honestly prefer the tighter soundstage of the original. And now, just to show you how contradictory this whole thing has made me, I will reverse my position for I Want to Tell You, which I have to admit is perplexing to me because I honestly felt that the bass was kind of on the same level as it was with Dr. Robert. But for whatever reason, I just feel that on this new mix, the entire song just soars more. So the new mix wins for me on this one. Hey, call me an audio hypocrite if you want. I don't care. Now, this brings me to what is not only my favorite track on the entire album, but one of my favorite Beatle tracks of all time, Tomorrow Never Knows. And I'll say up front, it's an absolute tie. In my opinion, the limitations of the recording technology used at the time, and I'm referring to that whole block stereo sound as I describe it, only adds to the mysterious quality of the song. And yet, I love the expansiveness of the newer mix just as much. The new mix is a smoother acid trip. The original mix is a bit more of an intense acid trip. But they're both really great. Again, I was not expecting to react the way that I did this time around. It's good to know you can still be surprised. By the way, I also want to add that this set also includes a new stereo remix for both Rain and Paperback Writer, which were the singles that were released at the same time as the album. I did do a comparison of those as well, and I will post that as a Patreon exclusive. So for extra bonus content, please become a patron supporter and make a monthly pledge. Again, I want to close by just saying, this is my experience listening. Your mileage may vary. So please share your listening experience in the comments. I read every single comment on this channel, even if I can't respond to every single one. Please let me know your thoughts. I think we're all anxious to share with each other. As always, if you like these videos, be sure to hit like, hit subscribe, and hit the bell notification icon so you never miss a video. And again, a big thank you to all my patron supporters who are helping me make more videos like this. If you'd like to be a patron supporter, please go to patreon.com/TJR the original. Everybody, thank you so much for watching. I hope you all stay safe and healthy, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.